Feature Friday.
The freshest. Wait a second. I just saw like 3 seconds of this video, and I just have to ask, is every freaking actor in Bollywood freaking
ripped to the gills
and beautiful? Is that just like part of nature in Bollywood? Dude, I'm in.
Some of them are looking saucy, dog.
They do, don't they? They look beefy.
Go on, let's have a watch of this. So this is Shreya Ghoshal's
first Bollywood song.
Ever. Yes, and I think she was like 16 years old.
Oh, goodness gracious.
She was very young here. So, okay. And apart from this lovely fella here, let's give it a watch.
All right.
Watch my biggest blockbusters online, anytime, anywhere on erosnow.com.
Cool, yes.
Salman Khan ki comedies, romance, or action movies, enjoy kijiye.
My God, I'm downloading this app.
Sign up kijiye, aur free mein dekhiye.
Look how biffy that guy is. He's so biffy. Oh, yes.
Oh, that was an ad. I was like...
Yeah.
Oh, right. Get going. No, sorry.
Yes. Cool progression. Cool.
Oh, she's just painting a face.
Oh.
Nice.
How cool. It's choreographed to perfection, isn't it?
Intriguing choice of that percussion because it sounds like 80s drumming.
I think it is very 80s pop indeed.
I'm interested. Go on.
The choreography is like perfect to the musicality.
Oh, probably a good time as well. I do want to say, like, I do read, especially me, I try to read every comment. Ballet,
I do too.
Ballet always tries as well, and I try too. Sometimes it's impossible because it's the numbers sometimes incredible. And
but so we do put in a lot of effort to read every comment.
So do watch out for like a little comment. Maybe I'm like a blue icon, and I always say Efra here. So if that, I try to reply. It's just sometimes it's very hard to reply to everyone. But another thing I think is probably good to address. No need to apologize if your comment is quite long.
Yeah, we learn through you, basically.
Yeah, I'm not a big fan of like going on Wikipedia or learning about stuff. Especially some of the questions that we have are so particular.
Specific, yeah.
It feels like I'm actually learning through you guys. I'm like, as you're all here present. So yeah, don't hesitate to drop comments, even if they may be lengthy. But if you do also have other sources, like I don't know, articles or websites that you think might be really good for us to read,
or
and stuff.
Or other videos where it explains the things that we're asking.
Yeah, that we can watch in our own time and stuff, and you know, also I guess nourish our knowledge. Mm. More than happy. I do also want to say that I think we make a lot of mistakes. This is not the best channel for like analyzing everything, and we attempt to, but. Certainly, we're not music geniuses, especially when it comes to the Indian music industry.
Yeah, but we're learning. This is a brand new, fresh experience.
Yes, so I do apologize if we, you know, sort of make mistakes that maybe, I don't know, really bad mistakes or
mix and match to others, yeah.
Concepts. Remember, this is completely brand new to us, but I'm super, glad and happy that a lot of you guys are very...
So supportive and open to help us learn through you too.
I was about to say that a lot of you are so knowledgeable on all this stuff and have a lot of involvement in actually making music. So that's obviously brilliant. Again, no need to apologize for lengthy comments. I think that's one of the things that I've been noticing lately. It's fine. It makes it more enjoyable to me. And we also have like mother and father. You guys have met father. They also read and we discuss a lot of this when we eat and stuff. So yeah.
Yeah, it's cool though.
Ah, these are tabla, the tipa version.
That's beautiful. Cool. Oh my God.
Jesus, she's good looking. Young Shreya, the voice. Bro, the fucking choreo to the percussion is meant
it's
to go
fantastic.
Back.
It's beautiful. I love the mystery. I love how you were like super mysterious about who's the main girl and all of this like the big blah blah blah
next
moments.
Level.
It's like it's really amplifying that mysterious feel to it all, and then bam, beautiful eyes, fantastic hair, like incredibly looking reveal. Woman. Yes. Yeah. And you're like, whoa.
Hey, she's an attractive ass woman.
What? This is fantastic. And all the dancers, they're all like, every action is so perfectly in sync to each other. I wonder how many hours it took to film this scene alone. Ah, oh, so cool. Shreya's voice though. That's fantastic. Musically speaking, brilliantly.
Oh, you're wild woman.
Yo! How hypnotizing is this?
I love it, it's a joke.
Yeah, this sequence, the sequences from a choreographing and filming standpoint are so different, and they're so scheduled. Like, you can see the storyboard set out exactly what angle in what moment.
Purposeful.
This must have taken days to film.
I think
only this scene.
I think what's really interesting about the few Bollywood scenes that we have seen, I think this would be Bollywood, similar to the song where we checked out Shreya as well, with where Priyanka Chopra was involved.
Mastani?
I think, yeah, might have been that name. And then also the one where Lal Ishka, where Arijit sings. Some of these scenes, they're very tight, so there's no... There's no filling images. There's no filler. Everything is...
There's no fluff.
Yeah, everything is pure. It's very tightly packed, and everything has a vision and a clear vision. And I think that's something that they might do best even for a music video. I know this is a scene of a movie, but even as a video song, as they call it there in the title, everything is very neatly packed and well made. I think that's probably the best way to describe it.
The specific attention to detail is so paramount in the making of the scenes. And I think that they're just so excessively detailed.
Yeah.
And that enhances every single moment, every look, every action, every turn of the head, every flick of the wrist, every situation is so perfectly highlighted.
I really want to watch my first Bollywood movie. So we've been discussing which one it should be the first. Mm-hmm. Perhaps let us know what you think would be the best to kind of start. I do only have one, request. The music has to be fucking outstanding in the movie. When movies have shit music, they just kill it for me. It's like, what are you doing? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, yeah, if you know any like that perhaps would... And maybe we'll even do like our thoughts after the movie. Mm. A video to kind of share our thoughts. Let us know what you think.
Absolutely.
It's no waste.
No. And everything is so cinematically perfect. So beautiful. Everything about it is gorgeous. Aww. Oh, it's so great. And musically, it's so hauntingly beautiful.
Oh, it was his mouth. It's sound from the... Check out the group.
Yeah, it's a mouth. Oh my god. Oh, how pretty is she?
Dude, she's good looking, dude.
Cool. It's beautiful.
I wonder what the flame represents.
Me too. Oh, the music!
Bro, just that arrangement.
The music.
Ah, boy.
Doom. It's magical. It's really, it's freaking magical. How beautiful finger modulation as well.
Yes. Oh. It doesn't go off. She's very good looking.
When was this? When did this come out?
What year is it? It feels a bit old schoolish.
It does, but it
certainly was... if it was Shreya Ghoshal's first song. In Bollywood.
First Bollywood song. Yeah.
Like in Bollywood. She's done that plenty now. So I would imagine. Do you know the year maybe?
I don't know.
It was 2011 when the video was posted on YouTube. So I don't know if that was when it actually released.
Could be.
It does feel like it was 10 years ago. Certainly, yeah.
Yeah. But I just love how he, the music is so haunting.
It's crazy. 2011 is 10 years ago.
Yeah, but it's fuck, 10, dude. Yeah, Jesus. Wow, crazy.
What the hell are the next 10 years going to look like, the metaverse?
Virtual reality.
Yeah.
That's it. I mean, this is fantastic.
Because then, you could put the headset
here
and you could be in
the video.
Yeah. Oh, shit, I'll be down.
Actually,
be down.
Yes.
The metaverse scares the shit out of me, but I'll be down.
But actually, take my money.
Yeah. I would buy. That's the problem. That's what scares me.
That I would actually
buy.
Yeah,
my impulses would be to
buy it.
If I have the means to, I'd buy it.
Yes, Zuckerberg, we would buy it. How cool is that?
Nice, even the flame fucking.
She's a brilliant actress. Oh,
how
cool!
How?
Do it again! That was brilliant! I love her voice! Shreya's voice is magical here. Bro, I got chills! I don't know what's happening!
It's such an experience.
It is. Ah, they have the dust.
I wonder what it means.
So it was like an offering. To, I suppose, maybe, I don't know. Sir, I am confused, but I love it. I want to watch all about it. That is so cool.
Silsila.
I'm going to search up the year this movie came out.
Okay, so it's for a movie called Devdas, 2002.
Oh, that's more than a decade.
It felt like 20 years. Yeah, something like that, along those last 19
2002.
Years.
So release date in the United Kingdom was in 2002.
So in India?
In India.
Do you know? So it goes like
this. It was originally released in 1955.
Holy shit.
Their first original story was filmed in 1955.
Wow.
Well, and this is a remake of that.
Here's the lyrics for those wondering, as we are. It goes, the weather has pandiculated.
Pandiculated?
Pandiculating is generally defined as the act of stretching oneself and yawning. Pandiculation.
Ah, so that's what the morning stretch is called, pandiculation.
However, our automatic pandicular response has far more significance than simply prompting us to stretch and yawn. So pandiculation is like...
stretching. It's like the tightening of... The air has tightened and stretched.
Well, the act of stretching. The involuntary stretching of the soft tissues.
Ah, so the air has stretched.
Fuck, okay. So the weather has pandiculated. It has involuntarily... stretched, it has been
changed, transformed.
But I think the use of the word pandiculation would be more to the
involuntarily stretched.
No, in their focus on involuntarily.
Mm. Mm-hmm.
It's a involuntary process.
Mm-hmm.
So it has involuntarily changed, but the focus is involuntary.
Okay.
It hasn't happened for a reason. It's happened for no reason.
That's complex English usage.
The rain has come all over again. A gust of wind will come and this lamp will extinguish. The connection of our love. I haven't let it extinguish. I was going to say, either represents her youth or love. The connection of our love.
The flame of love.
I haven't let it extinguish. Oh, my love, this lamp hasn't extinguished and nor will it. The lamp of my love, my beloved, come to me now. My beloved, come to me now. Along with this lamp is burning my heart, my whole body and my heart. Now come to me, my beloved, come to me now. And then it goes on, fa-sla, that dori di, which I think that's like the one of the things that repeats itself the most. There was a distance and separation, there was a distance and separation.
Is the chorus, is the chanting part in which it opens? Is it?
No.
Oh, okay.
I think the chanting part is my beloved, come to me now.
All right.
There was an ambience of detachment. My eyes are waiting and you were there, you were there, you were there, shining, sparkling and roaming with total joy. And here I was burning and here I was burning. The clouds thundered again. It was thundering and raining. There was a storm going on, but still it couldn't extinguish you. Oh, my beloved, this lamp, no matter how much this rain, the wind and this lightning bothers you, my beloved, come to me now, my beloved, come to me now.
Mm.
And it repeats itself until the end.
So at the end, I suppose it's like a plea to the gods to maintain the flame always shining.
Yeah.
To keep the flame alive.
Yeah, I would say so. I would agree. I'm just trying to see.
Cool. I like it. It's so cinematically beautiful. The whole sequence of images was so hauntingly great. Obviously, perfectly matched with the musical composition and the singing itself. It just really highlighted the whole need for the flame to be alive. Didn't? Oh, it's really great.
Yeah, I was trying to find out who the first singer was then.
I think it's like a choir.
No, the first singer in the 1954 version.
Ah, okay, yes, I see what you mean.
Yeah.
Mm, that's a great question.
So then this is years ago then, like when Shreya did her first Bollywood. I think she was very young. I read in one of the comments. By the way, all the information I say out is just coming from comments. So I do apologize if it's wrong on their behalf, but it seems all the comments are, what would you call it, informationally accurate. But yeah.
That was absolutely cool. That was really cool, man.
Very interesting. It's always cool to see the studio arrangements and also the video. So let us know, perhaps, if there is a live version of this. As you know, that's mostly our taste. The Indian music industry has changed kind of our perception on live and studio.
Mm-hmm.
I had never seen this approach to studio music being fuller and richer than the live version. The live version arrangements are different.
Are completely different. It's like hearing a brand new song.
Yes. So perhaps let us know your thoughts about it and goodbye.